Hey guys, welcome back to Hunter's Garage Gym. Today I wanted to talk to you about some principles that we've been using for our bulking protocol at the gym. And the main principles are gonna be high intensity training, which is gonna be training until you've achieved 100% of your maximum momentary exertion. And number two is gonna be pre-fatiguing supersets. Both of these ideas were popularized by Mike Mentzer. He was a bodybuilder in the late 70s, kind of at the end of the golden era of bodybuilding. He competed against Arnold Schwarzenegger, and he was the first person to compete at the Mr. Olympia contest and score a perfect 300. So he's a very accomplished bodybuilder, and he was extremely thick and dense and muscular. I did a lot of research about his style of training, and his style of training went against a lot of the principles at that time. Arnold and Franco and Ed Corney and everybody who was training was doing very high volume training. So it was a lot of sets, a lot of reps, a lot of time in the gym, sometimes multiple sessions per day. It could be 4 hours of training. And obviously it worked really good for them, but Mike Mentzer kind of went a different route, and he tried to not do more training, but tried to do more intense training. And it was all about getting to the point of maximum muscle exertion. So what he meant by that was, if you're gonna do something like a curl or a bench press, you're gonna go and say, I'm curling the weight. The first few reps aren't gonna build that much muscle. It's only gonna be the last few reps, and specifically the last rep of the set, that is gonna activate the growth mechanism in the body that allows you to grow your muscles. So if I'm doing bicep curls, and I could do 15, but I only do 8, and I do 3 sets of 8 at a weight I could have done 15, even though I'm getting more volume than the 15, I'm not getting as much out of the workout as if I would have just gone for 15 reps and gone as hard as I could in one set. So what he did was, he said, this is childlike to think that more is better. It's actually better is better, and the higher intensity that I can create, the more muscle I'm gonna build. So he went into the gym 3 to 4 times a week instead of 6 days a week, and the training would last about 45 minutes to an hour. And in order to achieve this 100% momentary muscle activation, what he did was, he would have people help him. So say he's doing curls and he gets to the point where he can't rep out anymore, he'd have somebody help him lift the weight up, he'd lower it himself, and he'd keep going through forced reps, and then eventually just holding, then eventually lowering, then having somebody lower. So it's all about getting the most intensity in that moment for your muscles as you possibly can. Another way that Mike Mentzer went about getting the muscles to 100% momentary exertion, which is the maximum intensity that you can have in that muscle, is by pre-fatiguing supersets. So if you're training something like biceps, he would start with a more isolation exercise, something like preacher curls or barbell curls, and he would just isolate the bicep, and he'd try not to use too many other muscles. At the end, maybe he's cheating for a few reps, but it's all focused in the biceps until the biceps don't have anything left. Then what he'd do is, he'd move on to a compound exercise, something like chin-ups, and since he had the lats fresh and he had the chest and the shoulders all fresh, he was able to rep out some chin-ups even though the biceps were obliterated, and that pushed the biceps even farther, thus stimulating even more growth in the training session. Okay guys, welcome back to Hunter's Garage Gym. Today I'm gonna show you the ab circuit. Super simple, 4 exercises. It's a great warm-up, and we use this every single time we're trying to get super shredded, which is, you know, 24/7. So to warm up, you're gonna have your legs out in front of you, hands behind your head. You're gonna crunch up and then back down, focusing all the tension on your 4 middle abs. Okay, you're gonna do about 15 reps. Next thing you're gonna do is leg raises. For the leg raises, you can bend the knees a little bit, pull the legs up toward your face, back down, and then up. I like to breathe in through the nose on the way down. As soon as my inhale stops, I exhale, come back up. After that, you're gonna go into bicycles or knee to elbow. So my knees are up towards my chest. I'm gonna go elbow to knee for 15 reps per side. And then lastly, to train the obliques and the upper lats, I'm gonna have my arm down at my side, and I'm gonna reach down towards my toes, then relax, contract, relax, and then I'll switch sides and do it again on the other side, and I'll go through that cycle 3 times. All right guys, so now I'm gonna walk you through some of the supersets that we do at the gym during lat and trap, as well as shoulder and arm day. So it's mostly gonna be pulling muscles. And the first superset we're gonna do is a neutral grip lat pull down into a bent over barbell row. So for the neutral grip lat pull down, you need to make sure that your grip is kind of curled in like this. Once I grip it like this, it's gonna activate the flexor muscles in my forearm. It's gonna activate my inside bicep, and those muscles are gonna link into the lower chest and the upper lats. And my goal here is to work the lower lats until absolute failure. So I'll get set up. I'll keep the chest high. I'm gonna stretch, pull my shoulders down, keep the wrist curled, keep the chest high, okay? Every rep pulling all the way down and up. And you don't wanna go with too much momentum. You want the muscles to be doing the work, okay? So I'm gonna do as many as I can. And then once I've achieved failure, I'm gonna go right on to the barbell row. So today we're gonna be doing Yates rows. For the Yates rows, I'm gonna grab the barbell with an underhand grip. I'm gonna bring my chest up. The bar is gonna be at about the knees. I'm gonna pull back towards my belly button with my lats, okay? What you don't wanna do is do a sort of upright rowing motion, which is here, and using the traps to do the movement. And you also don't wanna be using the low back too much and just doing a back extension like this. So stay in the same place, look forward, stretch, pull back towards the belly button. And since the biceps and the upper lats are already fatigued, you're gonna get really, really nice contractions in the lower lats. And our goal for both of these exercises is to be about 6 to 10 repetitions of each. All right, so next up, we're training the traps. For the traps, we have two different exercises again. One is gonna be the isolation exercise, and then one is gonna be the compound movement. So for the isolation exercise, we're gonna be doing shrugs. So you're gonna grab the barbell with a comfortable grip, stand up tall, relax the shoulders, pull them up towards the ears, and then relax, okay? And I lower the weight with my traps too. And I'm gonna perform 6 to 10 repetitions. And then when I can't do any more, I'm gonna grab a lighter weight and put my hands in a little bit, and I'm gonna perform upright rows. So for the upright rows, I want a big chest while my elbows coming out and flaring out to the sides. And again, I'm just working those traps. So here and down. And you can breathe out as you lift up, in on the way down. Again, 6 to 10 repetitions. Okay, so next up, we're gonna be training the shoulders. We're gonna be doing a movement for side delts, followed by a movement that's, again, for the side delts, but also the rear delts. So we're gonna start with side delt raises. You're gonna have the dumbbells in front of you, big chest. You're gonna pull up towards the side and back down. Up again, and make sure you actually lower the weight. I see a lot of people do these. They kind of jerk the weight up, and then they just collapse. The eccentric portion is one of the most important parts of the lift if you're trying to gain muscle, so make sure that you lower the weight every single time, okay? So you do those slow and controlled. You can go a little fast on the way up, but slow on the way down. You're gonna get 6 to 10 repetitions, and then you're gonna go to the behind the neck press. For the press behind the neck, you'll pick the barbell up, or you can take it out of a rack. What I wanna do is I wanna pull the weight down with my side delts and my lats, and then I'm gonna press up with my front delts. Pulling down, and then pressing up. And again, 6 to 10 repetitions until the shoulders are totally fatigued. Oh, to finish up the shoulder training, we have to hit rear delts as well. For the rear delts, today what we're gonna be doing is rear delt raises. So you're gonna bend over, big chest, you're gonna pull your elbows out to the sides, focus on that contraction in those rear delt muscles. Again, bring it up, slowly lower it. And every single rep, you can't just go through these reps willy-nilly. You have to find the muscles, find the contraction, and you can exhale on the way up, inhale on the way down. And you're gonna go to absolute failure, rest, and then do one more set. All right, guys, so next up, we're gonna be training biceps. Again, all these exercises are just a byproduct of what muscles you're working. So any of these exercises can be interchanged as long as you know the principles behind it. The first exercise we're gonna do, we're gonna put on the arm blaster. We're gonna grab the easy curl bar. and I'm gonna rep out bicep curls. So I'm gonna exhale on the way up, squeeze my biceps, slowly lower it. And again, slowly lower, keeping my chest high, letting my arms take the weight. Okay. Now, once you can no longer perform any repetitions, you're gonna go onto the pull-up bar, and maybe with the assistance of a partner if you need it, you're gonna knock out chin-ups with your hands facing you. So I'm gonna stretch at the bottom. I'm gonna pull my chest towards the bar. I'm gonna slowly lower. And again, pull the chest up towards the bar, slowly lower. Every single repetition until I get the biceps to maximum momentary exertion, which is the goal of the entire program.
This shit too easy for me now. Nigga Cole been going plat since back when CDs was around. What you sold out triple debt, I can't believe these fucking clowns. Look how everybody clapping when your 30 song album do a measly 100,000. If I'm betting on myself, then I completely double down. If you hated on a nigga, please don't greet me with a pound. I be staying out the way, but if the beef do come around, could put an M right on your head. You Luigi brother now. Trace my steps all in this game. You can see we cover ground. Back and forth from NC to New York when Jeezy had the crown. Vivid memories, niggas start to squeeze, we ducking down. So many shells left on the ground, it make the Easter Bunny proud. I get up, dust my clothes off. Sleep is the cousin of death, no plans to doze off.